Hello everyone, it's Candy Rosenberg and I wanted to show you a fantastic way of preserving your family memories in a home decor project using Spellbinders die cuts. We're going to start with a frame that I purchased that has three holes. Didn't matter except for the size. We're not actually using the insides. I've already taken it apart. Take the frame off. Remove the glass. We're going to get rid of all the insides, the frame, the paper, and the little piece that's in the back to protect it. Put that aside. We're not going to be using that for this project anyway. We're just going to expose the back piece that came with it, and I'm going to be using some vintage music sheets from that I received from some good friends in Australia. And we're going to use these sheets to create a collage background on the back of this board. So now I've completed the background, taking the music sheets and using a matte medium paste to place them down and collage the pieces. I then took the Spellbinders Nestabilities labels 25, and I used the largest label for the background, the black cardstock. The second size down I used to cut my granddaughter's pictures to fit right inside to be inset. On the black cardstock background, I also used Embossability to emboss it to give it a little texture. It's kind of hard to see in the video. See if I can do it. I then took, and I'll show you in just a moment, some delicate Golden Glitz ink, pigment ink from Sukuniko, and did the gold brushing in the background so that some of that texture comes out. When I do this one, you'll see it better. So we're going to go ahead and do that. I'm using the, like I said, the Golden Glitz Delicata, and it's from Sukuniko. And I'm going to just rub it very lightly, because I just want to get the embossed area covered. And you'll see that it starts to highlight the raised area of the embossing on the cardstock. Let's just work our way around. We don't have to go all the way in because we're going to have a picture in there. If you put too much ink towards the middle and you try to adhere a picture, it actually is a little difficult to adhere and may not stay very well depending on what adhesive you use. So we're just going to stay around the edges, just enough to where it'll bring up that texture around the outside edge of the picture once it's placed on there. See if we can pick some of that up. Picks it up a little bit. I'm just going to go ahead and use some of the mat that I was using to do the collage of the music sheets to do on the back of the picture to put it down on the paper. We're keeping this pretty flat because it's going in a picture frame. And place it right down top of the cardstock. Some of this out of the way. Now we have all three pictures of my grandbaby. We have the vintage music sheets in the background collaged, the labels 25 as the background for the pictures, and then use the second size down to actually die cut the pictures that we're going to put on the inside. So let's just put it all back together and take a look at how it looks all put together. So we're going to put the glass back down. Should be dry. Let's make sure we're all dry. Do let all the decoupage type covering on that back dry before you put it all back together. Let's turn it over. Put everything back in there. Let's get the glass. Those are all up. And there you go. Just need to clean up the glass. And there you have it. I know there's a little shine on there. I apologize. I have big fluorescent lights in here. So I'm going to put it down here better.